Hello, I'm FX Toy Cat, and I don't remember if I asked this before, but now there are skulk vines, will there be mossy deep slate bricks and cobbled deep slate? This is a good question, 5564, because it does seem very arbitrary that there are only two blocks in the game right now that can be mossified. There's stone bricks and then there's cobblestone. Why is it specifically those two? So we had some interesting thoughts from Kingly Dogs on the matter, a Minecraft developer, of course, responding to something about mossy deep slate tile and saying that he'd prefer to have a moss layer type of block which can be attached to anything. His dream is a block type that quite literally layers onto the texture, so you can't even see the space between the layer block and the block underneath. He said it before and he'll say it again, mossy X blocks have always been a mistake. Why should certain brick types only have moss? Everything should be mossable. And again, this is one Minecraft developer's opinions that has to be stated for anything else. However, he's basically saying, yeah, having mossy be a descriptor that only works in some specific cases doesn't make any sense, because you should be able to, if you can craft mossy cobblestone from this and this, you should be able to craft anything with vines to make a mossy version of that block. I mean, it makes just as much sense, right? And so I actually think this is a really interesting thought of, like, Minecraft has a kind of fundamental issue that it started just adding a ton of blocks. Mossy cobblestone is one of the oldest blocks that in retrospect probably makes sense not as block types, but as block states. Think about how in the update aquatic, they made it so every block could every partial block, I should say, can exist with water filling the rest of that block. Wouldn't it be cool if we also had lava logged blocks? Wouldn't it be cool if we also had snow log blocks? Those are huge technical challenges that I'm sure at some point they'll address. But the same thing kind of applies to the cracked version of blocks, or indeed to the mossy version of blocks. Why is it that only some blocks can be mossified? Why is it that only some blocks can be cut? Why is it that only some blocks can be made into stairs and slabs? Whenever you try to find like an in-universe explanation or even like a game balance explanation, it really comes up flat. And the simplest answer is that, well, they tried to limit the number of them because you could have every single block in Minecraft have stairs and slabs. Yeah, I'm looking at you, swaggiest stairs in Minecraft. You know, neverite blocks, why can't we make stairs out of them or slabs out of them? But obviously, like, there is a point where you have to say, okay, this is ridiculous, let's go back up. And so the line they've drawn is very interesting to me. And an interesting thought experiment, if you think you'd enjoy designing Minecraft, is what exactly would you draw the line at for the stairs things, for the water logging slash lava logging, etc., etc., etc. So with that said, let's dive into the second question. By the way, this is Q&A Saturday, the weekly series where I answer your questions, and you can subscribe if you want to see more of these. Did you know that greater than 99% of house fires happen to people who aren't subscribed to the channel? Bet you want to be subscribed now. Yeah, minor threats. That's how you get subscribers. Speaking of ways you get subscribers, Drake Aswell has the greatest idea. Okay, what if, now hear me out, Minecraft Earth update. This is a really cool idea. I think that Minecraft Earth kind of was a lot of wasted time, right? It's sad to see a lot of that infrastructure is gone. Even the lead developer from Minecraft Earth is now working on Pokemon Go. It's sad to see like all of this stuff go. Rather than just seeing it as a waste of all this money and all this time and all these resources, wouldn't it be cool if instead all of the interesting things they made just for Minecraft Earth could come into regular Minecraft? And sure, you can't add all of those variants of sheep and cow, etc. But I really do think having these little Minecraft Earth features, these tiny little bonuses, would be a really cool thing, and it would be a great way to make Minecraft Earth not a failure, but instead just a way to add content to Minecraft very indirectly. Speaking of very indirectly, Jura Jojo calls out my stance on Bedrock being better because he says, "Toy Cat, why do you dislike useless mobs being added to Minecraft?" I do, it's true, and yet you play Bedrock because Big Salmon. Can you name any uses for Big Salmon? And man, you destroyed me here. You're right. I can't criticize useless mobs while at the same time saying I love Bedrock because it has Big Salmon, because Big Salmon is a useless mob. Except, wait a minute, no, he's not, is he? If you kill Big Salmon, the largest variant of salmon, is more likely to drop bones than the other type of salmon, because I guess he's bigger, so he's bigger boned. Look, he's not a fat salmon, he's a big bone salmon. Shut up, stop bullying him. But because he drops more bones, that's actually a very useful thing for the survival game, because if you want to get bones and you don't want to wait for nighttime, or indeed if you're playing on peaceful, then the only other solutions to get bones are fossils, which are very rare, of course, or you can try and get a composter going, and both of those things will only give you bone meal. If you want bones, the only way is Big Salmon, and that's just another way that Minecraft Bedrock is better than Java, and that's why Big Salmon is the best, and that's why you will respect Big Salmon, dammit. Speaking of things you should respect, Froggies Can Fly says, "I'm not sure, was Forgetting all the sentences on the scripted joke, I didn't think you had a script. I pictured maybe a list of bullet points that you kind of freestyle from. And this was obviously on the Minecraft bloopers that I uploaded this week of just all the things that I messed up with over the last 6 months. Good job to Harrison for saving all of those bloopers, by the way. Very embarrassing to me, but good job to him for pulling that together. So interestingly enough, it's interesting because so many people think that my videos are scripted, especially when you hear me try and say the same thing over and over again. But in reality, as much as I'd love you to think I put that much like time and scripting of every single one of these videos, every single video, with very few exceptions, like 0.5% of the videos, aren't scripted at all. Sometimes, if it's a really complex video, I'll list out bullet points ahead of time. Like you say, I'll write down like 5 or 6 things I have to say in the video, because if I don't say them in the video, then I'll miss the entire point. And videos like this, of course, I have the questions ahead of time. But in general, I never script videos because I've tried scripting before. It's funny, my job before YouTube was effectively being a games journalist. So you'd figure I'd be so good at writing these sorts of things. I don't think I write myself very well. I don't think I write anything very well, to be entirely honest with you. I don't even understand grammar and stuff like that. You know all the sponsored videos I've been doing? I send the worst emails off. I don't know why anyone works with me. But basically, I'm very bad at writing. And I think I'm better at just, like, I think not only am I better at just speaking, probably, maybe, but also it's much more natural to just have a conversation where you're speaking off the cuff, where you're actually talking to someone. I'm talking to you as an audience. I'm not reading from this script that I have pre-prepared because I find that to be ridiculous. And the only reason that I'm bringing this up right here is because if you assume my videos are scripted, man, am I writing bad scripts. If this video right here is scripted, checks notes, then obviously it would be a very bad video, but it is not scripted. I am very good at not scripting my videos. Thank you very much for the praise. I like that. Speaking of things I like, ShadowFaxDog says, so you can only see questions with a question mark? Wow, you know this is the internet, right? So many people must be confused. Well, yeah, I figured I'd explain this. I mentioned it offhandedly in the last Q&A, but there is a section on YouTube that's existed for a couple of years now that allows you to search by comments that contain questions. I used to have to go for a whole bunch of effort to get Q&A Sassy questions. Now I can just search the channel by this, and it works pretty well. I mean, I get some questions that are rhetorical, like this one. Are you blind or what? You can't see the difference between blackstone brick and deep slate brick. I mean, they look kind of similar. If you see one without the other, you can kind of see how you might get confused. And then also you get comments like this. What's up with these ravines? And it's like, I'm not sure that I can make a Q&A Saste using what's up with these ravines, but let's try our best. What's up with these ravines? You know, isn't it crazy how ravines exist? Whatever. So that's on This Seed Breaks All the Rules. You want to go see the ravines he's talking about? You shouldn't. You should stay right here. And instead, we should move on collectively to the next question. Wow, the 6th question of this Q&A. This is a wonderful time to be alive. Because the next question comes in from Dime Gogov, a very Russian-sounding name. Or maybe it's, I guess it's probably Dime Gogov. Or maybe it's just a made-up name. Anyway, they say, could you make another video like this? Responding to the Political Compass Minecraft server, which ideology is the best? I made quite a few political Minecraft server videos, most famously, of course, being the Communist Realm experiment from like 2.5 years ago now. Crazy how fast time passes, huh? It's an arrow that only ever moves in one direction. We're only ever getting older and getting closer and closer to death. Anyway, so the interesting thing about, making those server videos is at first it was this really fun, wacky idea that I spent far too much time on, but I really enjoy the results of. And it was fun because I really enjoy not playing multiplayer. Let me just put it that way. I'm not a big fan of playing cooperatively with people. That's come up a ton, and it's true. And so it was fun to just run a server that people thought existed and then play around with things a bit. But then after a while, people started to realize I was there and they tried to mess with the video, or they tried to get in the video by being so interesting. And it's like, that's not how experiments work. When your experimentees are aware of it, it ruins some of the fun. And then I started like deliberately misleading people so they wouldn't know if they'd be in a video or not. But then people started to get the hang of that. And I think what I have to do is I have to make an experiment that works, even if people are aware of the experiment. I don't know if I will do that. There's a big part of me that says I don't like that people are requesting this from me, so I probably won't do it. But I feel the need to mention, will I do another political server video? I like the idea. I want to do it at some point, and I want to make sure I do it interestingly and different. And so yeah, that might happen soon. But obviously, I'm kind of caught up in the middle of moving all the way around the world for very complex reasons. I'll dive into the next question, because DoverCarp294 says, I like frogs, and did you know roads are really just frogs? Did you guys know roads are really just frogs? I didn't know that, but Then I realized maybe he was talking about toads, and then I decided to Google it in case that was true, because, you know, he seems very insistent about this fact, and as it so turns out, all toads actually are frogs. Toads are a subclassification of them, and so not all frogs are toads, but all toads are frogs, and therefore, if you look at the new Minecraft mob, because obviously frogs are coming to the game at some point, we don't know when precisely, but they've confirmed to not be scrapping the idea, to be bringing it at some point, alongside chess boats and alongside, by the way, this is from It's Bees, as you can see from the watermark in the corner. I really love this frog design, I really love this chess boat design, but look how beautiful swamp wood could be. If only swamps had their own trees instead of for some reason having oak trees, why do swamp trees drop apples? It makes no sense. Why do they just put vines on an existing tree? Why can't we have a new tree type? Look how beautiful green is. Look how nice those new green boats are. Imagine putting a chest in one of those new green boats. I'm just saying, we need a new update that changes the world. Speaking of things that we need, Dumb Belton says, thanks, Toycat. Did you ever find out how to use glowing on Bedrock? I feel so much better that when you couldn't figure out either. And you know, I'm glad that you felt better seeing my pain. But in case you are curious and you're watching this and you're also confused why glowing sacks didn't work, on Bedrock, not on Java, just on Bedrock, the way it works is you have to dye the sign and then you can use glowing. Is that intentional? Is it not? I don't know. Is the Java way unintentional? Is it not? Who knows? All I know is that Potato of Memes is a very serious comment. And I want to really be quite serious here about the sadness I think I've brought on, because Potato Meme says, personally, I don't like it when you say 99% of people who aren't subscribed will have a house fire. It legit scares the heck out of me. Could you please change it to be more mild than a house fire? Like, have bad luck or something still bad, but not scary, please. And yeah, this made me really rethink the line of inquiry where I say that greater than 99% of house fires happen to non-subscribers, because it made me realize that I have to be extra diving down and letting people know, hey, if you are scared of house fires, you know, they are terrifying. They're not a good thing to happen. You really need to be subscribed to the channel. Did you know, for instance, that greater than 99% of alligator attacks happen to people who aren't subscribed to the IBX Toycat YouTube channel? I bet you didn't know that fact, and now you do know it. I'm just saying, you might think you're safe up there in Minnesota. You might think you're safe over there in the big city in London where there's no alligators anywhere nearby. But believe me, you're not safe. You better watch out. You better not shout. You better something something. I'm telling you why. Your boy IBX Toycat is coming to town, probably with some arson intent. Anyway, so thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, because I'll see you all in another one that isn't this one, unless this is the last video ever and I died in a house fire. Actually, there's a big hurricane happening just a little while after I record this video. So let's hope I'm fine there, huh? Maybe I should fly away from here, long away from the hurricanes. But yeah, first hurricane of my life, potentially. Very excited to see how that goes. I'm also excited to see you go after this. Goodbye.